I'm going to do one of the problem from the chapter 9, it's number 43. Here we are given xt as a white sense stationary process, and the autocorrelation function of the x is given as 5 of del t. And we have to find the expected value of y square t and the output power spectrum when we are given this equation y dash of t plus 3 y of t plus x of t. This one is the derivative of y of t. So when we take the transform of the whole equation, we will get this term z omega y omega plus 3 of y omega equals to x omega. So like once we rearrange the whole thing, we get it as x omega by 1 by 3 plus z omega. This term we can represent as h of omega, since in terms of transform, like y omega can be represented as a product of x omega and h omega. Now the second one is rxx of tau is given as 5 of del tau. So this one, if we take the transform, we will get the input spectrum, power spectrum. So this one, it comes up as 5, since the delta goes up because it's 1. And for us to get the output power spectrum is the product of the input spectrum and magnitude, square of the magnitude of h of omega. So this one is 5, and this one, since there's a magnitude, so this one we could present as conjugate of 3 plus j omega and 1 minus 1 into 1 by 3 minus j omega. So this one we could do it as 5 by 9 plus omega squared. If we take the transform of the output power spectrum, we will end up with the autocorrelation function of the output. So SYY of omega, if we take the transform, we will get it as RYY of t. To find RY, to take the transform, we are going to use the formula e to the power minus alpha of t. If we take the transform, it's going to end up to alpha by alpha square plus omega square. So like once for this one, if you're going to use this one, RYY of tau, it would end up as e to the power minus alpha is 3 tau, and the constant term, it's going to come up as 5 by 6. And the other term that we need to find is e of y square of t. This one, it is equal to r y y when the value of tau is equals to 0. So this one would be the term, the fraction 5 by 6. So for the second part, we are also given the same equation, except for the part that there is one more u of t in the right side. And we have to find the expected value of the y square of t and the rxy in terms of t1 and t2. For this one, we can use the same system function from the previous, 3 plus z omega from there. For this one, if we need to take the transform, we are going to use the formula e to the power minus alpha of t u of t equals to, it transforms to 1 by alpha plus z omega. So this one we're going to use over here. For this one, h of t equals to e to the power minus 3 of t in terms of u of t. Now for this one, e of y square of t equals to, for the white noise q of t, h of t whole square. For this one, I can represent q of t as 5, and this one I can represent from infinity to infinity as h of alpha square d alpha. And this one, if I want to use this one, I can limit from 0 to infinity. So I could do it from 0 to infinity and e to the power minus 6 alpha in terms of alpha. So like from 0 to t, sorry. So for this one, I could do it as e to the power 6 alpha by minus 6 from 0 to t. So this would come up as 5 by 6, 1 minus e to the power minus 6 of t. And this one is good when the value of t is greater than or equal to 0. And the other term that we are supposed to find out is rxy in terms of t1 and t2. This one, I could represent it as rxx 1 t2 with convolve with h t of t2. So this one I could put it as 5 of del t2 minus t1 convolve with h asterisk of t2. If I consider like over here, I'm considering that t2 is greater than t1, so I could write it this one as 5 e to the power minus 3 t2 minus t1 u of t2 minus t1 and u of t1. So just like t2 is greater than t1. So I think it's gonna get like this. Thank you.